By the end of this video, you're going to know about three different no-code app builders that you can use instead of Bubble. You're going to learn about the similarities to Bubble, as well as the differences and what makes them stand out from Bubble. I use Bubble most of the time these days when I'm building a no-code app, but these other tools I'm about to show you are also really good, and maybe one of them will be right for your project. So let's jump into Flutter Flow. Flutter Flow is optimized for native phone apps, native mobile apps. What that means is if you want to build an app that's going to be uploaded to the iPhone App Store or the Google Play Store, Flutter Flow is a really good option to look into because you're able to build your apps natively for mobile, whereas Bubble is more optimized for web apps. Flutter Flow can also build web apps, but if you wanted to build a web app, I might recommend Bubble over Flutter Flow. Another benefit of Flutter Flow is you can export your code, which you cannot do in Bubble, and that's really helpful if you don't want to lock yourself into the Bubble ecosystem. Another difference between Flutter Flow and Bubble is in Flutter Flow, you have to connect a database separately. What that means is you would connect a database such as Firebase or Supabase to Flutter Flow, and you'd have to manage both of them separately, and it requires a little bit more technical knowledge to set up. So this comes with its own pros and cons. On the pro side, you're not locked into the Bubble ecosystem in the same way you would be if everything was all integrated, but it's a little bit more complex to set up. So those are some of the similarities and differences when you're considering Flutter Flow versus Bubble. Be sure to check out our full comparison between Flutter Flow and Bubble. We have a video that you can check out on that. Just search No Code MBA, Flutter Flow, Bubble. Okay, the next alternative that I'm going to talk about is WeWeb. So WeWeb is similar to Flutter Flow in that you have to connect your own database on the back end. With WeWeb, you're going to be building your front end, and then you're going to build on top of a back end. So that back end could be, as I mentioned before, something like Firebase or Xano is a really popular one. WeWeb also allows you to export your code, so you're not locked into the WeWeb ecosystem the same way you are with Bubble. When you're thinking about whether to use WeWeb or Flutter Flow, I would think about whether you want to build a web app or you want to build a mobile app. As I mentioned before, Flutter Flow is more optimized for building mobile apps. So if you want to upload to an app store, I would go with Flutter Flow. If you want to build a web app, I would go with WeWeb because WeWeb is more optimized for just building web apps. So on a high level, you have Bubble, which is its own ecosystem. It's a little bit easier to get started in and build in. Flutter Flow is going to be really good if you want to have a separate backend and you want to build mobile apps. And WeWeb is going to be really good if you also want that separate backend, you're a little bit more technical, and you want to build web apps. So that's a high level difference between Bubble, Flutter Flow, and WeWeb. So there's one more no-code tool that I'm going to talk about, and that is Wappler. So Wappler is the most technical of all of these options. So Wappler, even you can see on their homepage, they call themselves low-code software. So what that means is there is a little bit of code that's going to be involved here. You can very easily integrate code into your Wappler app. You're also able to export all of the code, host it anywhere you want. You're also going to have to connect your own backend database, similar to WeWeb and Flutter Flow. So I would recommend Wappler if you are more technical. Perhaps you are already a software developer and you already have that skill set and want to be able to add code to your project really easily. If you're already really comfortable with backend databases and setting all of that up yourself, in that case, Wappler might be one that you want to check out. So I hope that this was a helpful overview of three alternatives to Bubble. If you do want to learn more about building with no-code, specifically building with Bubble and Flutter Flow, because we have courses on both of those platforms, our no-code MBA, check out the link in our description or go to no-code.mba to check out all of our full in-depth tutorials. If you have any questions at all, please just leave a comment below. Otherwise, I'll see you in the next video.